All right, so in this video, we're going to go ahead and show you how to default the iQUBE2 Junction Box. And so what you see here is we have our iQUBE board that's set up with four different simulators because we want to make sure that all of our cells are actually receiving some kind of a signal. And suppose you're going through some sort of a configuration attempt and maybe things aren't going the way you like, there was a mistake that was made somewhere, we don't know where it might be, or you're encountering this particular piece of equipment and we don't know who worked on it in the past and we just know that there's something going on. So one of the things that we would often suggest, particularly with the iQUBE2, is to, you know what, let's go ahead and default and let's just start from scratch and see if we can get it going again. So we're going to show you how to default this. A few things that we have to be aware of to try and find. One is, on the side of the board, you see there's a slide switch here, and it's labeled CFG for config, and it's also labeled off on the other side. So we have to have location of this. There's also, on the other side of this connector, there is a little rubber push button that's labeled S1 here. And those are located, again, just on either side of the 4-pin power connector that's coming in. And the first step we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and place the iQUBE2 board into config. So we'll slide that to the side that says config. We notice all of the lights for the load cells and everything goes off. The only thing we should see is this heartbeat light that's still going. In this particular condition, then, we want to find that rubber push button on the other side. And we're going to press and hold that button down. So pressing and holding, we continue to hold it. We see the lights here start to flash. And when they finally come back solid green after doing all their flashing and stuff, then we can go ahead and let go. Then what we can do is take our power connector. We're going to remove that. And then apply power to the system one last time. And the reason we do that particular step is that it allows the new configuration to read these very small dip switches that are here to make sure that we're in the right communication mode. And then we're going to go ahead and slide this back to the off position. We should see all of our load cell lights, if they're connected, come back to a green state. And the iQUBE2 is now in a default state and ready to go. Mm-hmm.